Welcome to Ads Manager 2.0. Now, for a lot of you, I assume this is something that sounds relatively familiar, but on Madgicx, we've really made an effort to ensure that the efficiency and your analytical ability on this tool is at the highest level. So we're going to start right at the top with some of our more basic features and then take a deep dive into each of the different features across this tool. To start, we look at our time period tab. Now on this tab, we can choose to use one of the ready-made presets to look at the last 7 days, 14 days, 30 days to identify trends. We can also set up a custom time period if we want, but for the point of this example, we're going to be looking at the last 30 days. We click update and all of our data now looks at the last 30 days. Now, when we click this button over here, which is our refresh button, we make sure that the data being displayed to us is as accurate as possible. All of the data comes through, we make sure that it's correct. And if we see any discrepancies or anything that looks a little bit older, we can simply click this button again and refresh the data that's in front of us. When we move to the left, we look at both of our filtering options, right? We've got a filter data option. This data looks at either filtering by metric, by name, by status, funnel stage, or ID. And just to show a basic example of how this filter works, we can simply click metrics, campaigns, and let's say we want to set a minimum spend limit. So we want to look at only campaigns that have spent more than £10. We can simply click apply and the Ads Manager 2.0 table will adjust and show us the information with campaigns that have spent more than £10. If we want to take an even deeper dive into our filtering ability, we can use the smart filter. Now, this little part over here is known as the ARR filtering ability or a smart filter. We can filter just by our funnel stage. So if we want to only look at campaigns within acquisition, we apply that filter and now we can see only our acquisition campaigns. If we want to do the same for retargeting, we simply click the retargeting part of things, click apply filter, and we can see the relevant campaigns for retargeting as well. We've also got the ability to filter by placement, device, gender, age, or country using this functionality. Now to take a deeper dive into the different tabs that we see in front of us. So we've got our campaign tab, our ad set tab, our ads tab, and finally our all assets tab. This is very similar to your native ads manager. However, the functionality on each tab extends way further. On our campaigns tab, we can simply select which campaign we want to be working with. We can look at what we can do to this campaign, pausing it, starting it, setting budgets, increasing, decreasing budgets, bid strategies, duplications, deletions, and changes in the name across the board. We can also look at the specific creatives for this campaign. And this is a tab that you're going to see on the ad set tab as well. And we can go straight in and we can look at how our ad copy is doing, how our creative is doing, as well as which combinations of great creative and great copy we haven't tried yet and we have the opportunity to try. When we go into the actual table itself, you can see the breakdown is simply, I guess, a table, but there are a whole bunch of different parts of this table that will be quite new to you. The first part is our color coding. If you hover over our different color coded campaigns, you can see it highlights them by their specific funnel stage, right? So we can see our retention campaigns, our retargeting campaigns, campaigns that haven't yet been identified. And we can simply reclassify campaigns and ad sets in the ad set tab, which I'll show you in the next step. We can also view what's gone on in our campaigns, right? Let's say we are managing our campaigns, turning things on, turning things off, and running a business at the same time. You can get a bit confused as to when you turn that off or when you increase the budget or when you made a change to the campaign. You can simply come into latest actions and it will show you exactly who did what to the campaign, when they did it, how they did it, by how much they increased or decreased, or what they changed in the campaign. You can also edit your budgets directly from this tab by simply inputting which budget you want to put, as well as change which metrics you want to view. Once you've set up, you know, your perfect metric breakdown, you can come over here, save a column preset, and click into the view whenever you arrive on the Ads Manager 2.0 tool. The latest actions tab will also go through if you've got automations running. Over here, we can see an automation has been run. And this is a campaign scaling automation. We can see what the automation did, when the automation did it. It allows you to keep track of every single element of what is going on in your account. Obviously, our green dot over here means the campaigns are active and the grayed out dot means that the campaigns are inactive. When we scroll all the way to the right at the bottom over here, we get to see our performance over time and any active optimizations that we have on the campaign. So we can view our performance in a graphical format specifically for that campaign over our selected time set. So over here, we can see we had an increase in performance and it started to slump. We can immediately go in and investigate what happened to this campaign that there was this slump. If we want to click on these three dots, we can go into Facebook, view whatever we need to in Facebook. Let's say we need to access parts of our tracking. We can easily access Facebook by clicking the View on Facebook button over here. When we move to the ad set part of things, we now have a deeper dive into our campaign. So for the point of this example, we're going to be looking at the Madgicx AW 2022 campaign under an ABO budget breakdown. We look at which ad sets we've got running over here. We can see we've got a full funnel pretty much running in this campaign. And we can see which actions have been performed across the campaign, whether it was an automation performing the action or one of our media buyers. When we look at the budgets, we can obviously edit our budgets over here, as well as edit the metrics that we need to view our performance. Now, let's say we want to make changes to a specific ad set. We can once again click our Manage Assets tab, and we get introduced to a whole bunch of functionality. Again, start and pause, increase and decrease, setting budgets, bids, and you can set bid strategies. You can duplicate spending limits across the board, whether you're setting them, removing them, increasing or decreasing them, as well as apply some automation optimizations to these specific ad sets. You can see over here that this will look at the best performing demographics for your specific account and optimize that ad set accordingly. We can also go in and we can create a bid test for winning ad sets by simply clicking the setup bid test. And by clicking this button over here, we get taken to Madgicx's very intuitive bid testing tool. And this allows us to immediately identify a winning ad set, say that we want to scale it even further, try and get the lowest bid that we possibly can, and run a bid test on it. As I mentioned, you're easily able to do a full creative analysis by clicking on the Analyze Creatives tab. Finally, we can go into the Ads tab once we've selected which ad set we want to look at. And on this point, we've now got a whole bunch more functionality specifically for our ads on top of the latest actions. And if we scroll all the way to the right, we can see our performance. On top of our standard set, we've got a little bit more specifically for the ads. We can preview the ad by clicking this icon over here. We can go look at the ad on Facebook by clicking the link icon over here. And we can make any edits that we require and it will update automatically on Madgicx. We can then select an ad. And we can look at exactly what we can do with that ad. If we're starting it, pausing it, duplicating it, or changing some of the naming conventions, we can easily do so from this menu. Then we move on to the All Assets tab. Now, this is a really cool tab. It allows you to see everything in one place, from your campaigns to your ad sets, all the way down to your ads. And it gives you all of the functionality that you would have in terms of managing those assets when you click on the relevant asset you would like to manage. Once again, you can see all of the different actions that are taking place on your account, from increasing budgets, decreasing budgets, turning campaigns on, turning campaigns off, or creating or deleting new ads. The goal with Ads Manager is to give you a full and in-depth approach to exactly what is going on in your account, whether that's who is doing what on my account, whether how my campaigns are performing, what funnel stages are performing compared to other funnel stages, how my funnel is working. Is my acquisition feeding my retargeting? Is my retargeting feeding my retention? If we identify performance, we can scale. If we identify down performance or negative performance, we can downscale. If we see opportunities for bid tests, automations, additions of ad sets, duplications of campaigns, ad sets or ads, we can do everything in one place with the Madgicx Ads Manager 2.0.